Gene Jennings has been expounding on autos for over 30 years, after stretches as a cab driver and as a technician in the Chrysler Proving Grounds Impact Lab. She was a staff author at Car and Driver magazine, the principal official supervisor and previous president and proofreader in head of Automobile magazine, the organizer of the blog Gene Knows Cars and previous car journalist for Good Morning America. She has lifetime grants from both the Motor Press Guild and the New England Motor Press Association. Search for more vile gossip sections later on. It was 2006. We were driving a Bugatti Veyron 16.4 over the Florida Panhandle from Jacksonville to Panama City, simply because I couldn't persuade Bugatti to give me a chance to be the first to drive its colorful powerhouse, the world's quickest auto around then, the distance crosswise over America. One shining case had landed in time for the Amelia Island Concours d'Elegance, where the journos masked for their snappy test drives out the front drive of the Ritz-Carlton, down a short extent of the A1A, and back to the Ritz. Not sufficiently far for me. I needed to take the Veyron in the greater part of its 16-chamber, 1001 strength, $1.3 million dollar brilliance on an across-the-nation spectacle of a street trip. Never damages to inquire. I inquired. Once the Bugatti folks quit hyperventilating, I clarified that the waterfront experience would be contained completely inside the territory of Florida, from the Atlantic Drift to the Gulf of Mexico. My mystery goal, be that as it may, was to be Vernon, Florida, home of the colossal Errol Morris exemplary narrative about a town in the Panhandle with the most noteworthy per capita populace of nationals who'd passed over or whacked off an appendage for protection cash. Google Stub City. The Swiss head of Bugatti advertising thought it comical. He appeared in a van with two or three German mechanics to tail us and a fizzled French Formula One driver to fill in as my chaperone. I accompanied a picture taker from Germany and a standout amongst the most scandalous of terrible kid auto magazine tech editors, the irrepressible Don Sherman. Sherman had his own purpose behind going, and it had nothing to do with a Veyron to Vernon. When we surrendered searching for nice, he requested me to veer south to the handgrip of the Panhandle, recognizably known as the Redneck Riviera. The Don was meaning to covertly execute the Veyron's first launch control launch in bondage. I had just a simple thought of what he was discussing, however it seemed like it would have been energizing. Particularly when he donsplained that I ought to by no means let the PR honcho know. Driving with Sherman habitually included me intensely petitioning my God to give me a chance to experience this one time. Once more. Conditions were bad on Highway 30A, a tight, mangrove line 2 path simply out of Port St. Joe. It was still deceptively moist from a morning precipitation. The Shermanator, absolutely courageous, arranged the Veyron straight down the center of the unmarked landing area, braked to the floor with his left shoe, and held it tight while he pounded the quickening agent with his correct foot and held them both down. What? No, Don. No, Don. I yelled, without any result as he came all of a sudden off the fasteners. The relentless 1001 horsepower, 64-valve quad-turbo Veyron squirted out a little too advance before it prematurely ended as the wheels lost hold. Nothing. Obviously Sherman attempted it an entire another pack of times before he quit. That was my first launch control minute. The most recent, however without a doubt not last, dispatch practice is significantly more later. It likewise included two individuals in the auto, just I was driving this time and it wasn't an auto. It was Jeep's sad. Not sorry form of a SUV, the 2018 Grand Cherokee Trackhawk, the most capable SUV ever. The specs are currently incredible, 6.2-liter supercharged Hellcat V8, 707 strength, 645 pounds to foot of torque. 3.5 seconds from 0 to 60 miles per hour and a 180 mile per hour top speed. Furthermore, it weighs 5,350 pounds. I need it. You need it. The general population who don't need it don't make a difference. My driving accomplice, mentor for the track occasion was a resigned NASCAR driver of some eminence, so I won't state its identity. Time at the private street course Jeep leased for the day started with hot laps. Rankling hot laps. Fun, yet I was in it for the launch. My amigo was for it. We held up till everybody went to lunch, at that point pulled up toward the beginning of a straightaway as smooth as a child's rear end. We went through the bore. There is not much, drive mode in track. Draw in launch catch on focus support. Left foot brake to the floor and hold. Right foot quickening agent to the floor and hold. Disregard the savage kicking and growling in the engine as the supercharger ends up to max help. For one pulse, I grinned at the pro. We were both glad. And after that I jolted my left knee noticeable all around, and we were in Jeep heavy rocket mode. Just the fakers in the cockpit were shouting the distance down the long straight like young ladies. Neither of us was chuckling. The shout from the correct seat diverted into one long yell from my teacher, "Brake, brake, 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 brake." Truth be told, I had officially scoured off speed. Obviously, the brakes are from Brembo, and was bowing right, perfectly through the cones toward the finish of the straight. I took a gander at him. He was gasping a bit. "Man," he said. My heart was leaving my rear end. We both began giggling. What's more, we did it an entire another pack of times.